Hello, gentle viewers. This is Ev Guardian welcoming you back to Out of the Park Baseball 23 with the Tampa Bay Rays. A quick programming note. Normally, I don't do batch recordings on OTP. However, I'm going to be out of town later on this week. And I won't be back till the middle of next week. So that's why I am going to be recording the next episode in this series right after this one. So if you guys have comments or suggestions, don't be alarmed if I don't listen to them. It's because I didn't see them until after they were even recorded. So just a heads up on that. So without any further ado, let's talk about what happened. Well, last season didn't go so great. 88-74 is perfectly respectable in a lot of ways, and still almost 20 games out of first place. We were only 4 games out of a wild card spot, so there's still some room to be hopeful. But we don't have as much money for extensions because we've already offered 2 very large extensions to John Lackey and Albert Pujols. Now, I am going to have a fairly substantial amount of money for one-year projects. So that is perhaps one advantage that we're going to have. But a lot of free agent room would actually disappear once Lackey and Pujols sign their extensions, so we'll see what happens. I'd love to bring back Matt Merton. I'd love it a lot, but he is quite correctly, I'm going to get $18 million, and I can't argue with that. I can't argue he doesn't deserve it, but I equally cannot pay him that amount of money. So we're going to have some interesting decisions to make as the season progresses. We are non-tendering a few backups just to save some cash. And in the possible scenario where Pujols or Lackey choose not to re-sign, we're also going to offer them 1 year qualifying offer. Now, the interesting question here is, do we offer Matt Merton a qualifying offer? And here's the thing. In his career, he has only briefly earned more than $9 million. And he's already 34. My biggest concern is if we don't if he takes us up on our offer, I have no money. And I do need some to fill a couple of holes. We don't have many holes, but we do have some. Now, the best way to fix some of these holes is just get good fuckers, aka Alex Rodriguez can't hit 224 again. And, look, I'm going to level with you. I don't mind Schwarbs being a little bit less effective because I do think there's lots of upside here. But A-Rod is making way too much fucking money to be hitting, a chump. I could trade him. Now, that would be interesting, wouldn't it? That would be interesting. He can't actually play short anymore. He only wants to play for one of 2 teams. He wants to play either for the White Sox or for the Marlins. I mean, we can try. But we're going to wait to talk to free agents file just so that the AI doesn't freak out thinking he's got a 2-year deal when he doesn't. So let's go ahead and advance time. I already got coaches signed, right? Yeah, I've got offers coming. Let's do it. Aleix Soler is already saying he can get a better job, and I'm just not going to fight with that. Henry Rodriguez signed, Mr. Bjorkman. wants more money or a better job. What was this trade about again? Oh, trying to get Cocoa Crisp. Okay. Yeah, I will happily give you Liqueur because I'm not going to keep him anyway. Where is he? Yeah, here we go. Submit offer. And that'll hopefully fix the center field problem because we're not going to be bringing back McLouth. We can't afford it. And Sakura signed, so we're still waiting on our two hitting coaches. Mr. Soler, I'd love for you to be my coach. I'll give you 400 grand to take that honor. Okay, we got Pujols. That's amazing news. It was fascinating. All of a sudden, remember, in this last proposal, like, give us Sam Lacure. That'll solve all my problems. Not to, like, get fucked. Yeah, I'm gonna make this trade because I'm not keeping any of these four players anyway, so let's get it done. Okay, keeping Pujols is good. Getting Coco Crisp is even better. Coco should at least be as good as Nate McLouth, possibly better, and is still a very fine defender. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, aka trading Alex Rodriguez. Only wants to play for two teams, wants to play for Miami or Chicago. Oh, right. We're waiting, aren't we? And we got Lackey too. So the actual amount of money I have for agents is now none. So we're gonna if we're going to be active in the market at all, we're gonna have to get rid of some salary. And that probably comes from trading A-Rod. If either team wants him, and they may not, they may decide, nope, we don't care. Mike Rochka, I would love for you to stick around. Happily. Ooh, a gold glove for. Wait, what? Oh, Matt Merton. Silver Slugger for Albert Pujols. No surprise there. He also got MVP again. I honestly thought we'd have a chance at getting Cy Young too because John Lackey did have a very, very good year. I'm curious as to how close we got though. Like, I wonder if Lackey was like second or third. Like, he didn't even get any first place votes, which I find pretty funny, but whatever. Anyway, cool story, bro. All right. I still need to hire two new hitting coaches because he's being a jerk. I just need bodies at this point. It sucks. I really don't want to have to pay a mediocre coach that much money. But it's got to be done. I've got to have a hitting coach. And yes. Give me Reggie Ritter. He seems reasonably okay. Reasonably. I'm literally offering you just like, here's some money. Do you want to play coach for me? Which is a pretty good deal, I think. All right. Let's get some Hall of Fame votes in. Do 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 do. Look, if the fans want Ron Gant in, I'm not gonna stop him from getting in. I'd rather help him get in and help him off the ballot. Sean Bergman, meh. Rusty Greer, somewhat meh. There's nothing wrong with him as a player, but compared to the average Hall of Fame left fielder, he just doesn't measure up. So I think he has to be off my ballot for now. I'll vote for Juan Guzman. It's a waste of time, but I'll try it. John Jaha. This is hilarious to me. Like, John Jaha was like a middling first baseman for the A's. But I think for a couple other teams, too. He played for Milwaukee before that. And yet he's a frickin' Hall of Famer, not just a Hall of Famer, but like an inner circle Hall of Famer, by getting over 3,000 hits and over 600 homers, which is just hilarious to me. Definitely voting for CJ. Jeff Jenkins, nope. Ramon Martinez, yes. Mike Matheny, no. I don't mind Raul Mondesi, so I'll vote for him. I'll vote for Musa Naholtz too. Australia's own Dave Nelson. Mike Piazza, even more ridiculous in this game than he was in real life, which was plenty ridiculous. I'll throw a vote to Tim Salmon. And Jason Schmidt. And John Smiley. And John Valentin and Bernie Williams. And submit the ballot. Oh, wow. Like, I get it. Chris Sale isn't perfect, but a 26-year-old starting pitcher hitting free agency is ludicrous. I think what's happening is starting to see a lot of players getting priced out. A lot of teams are getting priced out. All right, we gotta trade A-Rod. And he'll only go to two teams, so let's see what we could get. So let's start by talking to the White Sox. You don't really have much that entices me. And look, as much as I get it, this is about saving money. I'd like at least to get something for my money. Give any prospects? Like, you would never give me Joey Gallo. I'm not even gonna bother asking. But maybe Shea Simmons is fair. I do need more pitchers in the majors. Wow, you want Simmons? That's, you're ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Let's talk to Miami. Oh God, they're even worse. I guess my issue is, how bad are we willing to let the team get? Like, how shitty a deal am I willing to take? I don't want Dustin Pedroia. I don't want Moose Tacos. I wonder if they give me Aviles, not because Levis is amazing, but because he's at least acceptable at shortstop. I can't give you Sardinas. That leaves me with no depth at shortstop. And Aviles isn't that good. And I could always just make Sardinas play shortstop. Although he can't hit at all. So I guess that's a fair point. But if I offered you Roberto Perez. No, that doesn't fly with you, okay. I gotta give you Sardinas. I hate it. I despise it. But this gets rid of a giant millstone off of our team and gives me the financial flexibility to maybe make a move or two. So this had to happen. It sucks. I wish it didn't have to happen, but it did. Now I can at least get in on like a mid-tier free agent or two. So first thing we need to figure out is where do we have holes? Center field is going to be filled by Coco Crisp. That's already dealt with. And maybe get some Broxton time in there too, although I do think Broxton will be better off in a corner. It's at least worth considering. I need an everyday left fielder because I don't want Schwarber playing in left field at all. Schwarber is here to designatedly hit. That is his only role for the Tampa Bay Rays. I need a backup infielder, and I need probably one or two relievers. So let's start with players we can actually afford. I'm not going to pay premium tier money for a reliever. I'm just not built that way. Like, to be clear, we are very deliberately pulling out some frickin' bargain barrel offers. Give me, you miscreants, outfielders. Okay, Shin Shu Chu, if he were slightly better defensively, would be a really good fit for this club. Melky Cabrera is an even worse defender than Shin Shu Chu, but has the value of being quite cheap. Let's just ignore a lot of these names here. Really? Melky Cabrera is that good a hitter? You could bring Andre Ethier back, but I don't think that makes sense. And he's so cheap, too. But then again, he's not a very good left fielder. That's kind of the rub here, right? I'd love to get Denard Span. I can't afford that. Like, not even thinking about it. Adam Lind wants a bunch of money. Jeez. Is there like a compensation option here? Ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-bow. I think this might be it. Let's do less than 8 million. That works surprisingly well. Okay, great. Interesting. If Brian Goodwin were a better defender, I would strongly consider this, actually. Very strongly consider it. Could try bringing Seth Smith back, but I think that would be a poor choice. Well, I never had Seth Smith, did I? I did not. Smith is a really good all-around player. But 6 million is also most of my free agent budget. But maybe that's okay. I mean, there's always Gerardo Parra, but the problem with Gerardo Parra is he has one offensive skill. He can hit for average sometimes. That's not really good enough for a team that hopes to contend. Seth Smith has pretty good plate discipline, decent gap power, and isn't that far removed from a really good season. The thing is, wanting reasonably good defense is what's hamstringing me. I could just say, fuck it. And just pick the best hitter and let the chips fall where they may. If Milton Bradley could play the field at all, I'd consider it. Because he's so good at taking walks. That makes him incredibly valuable, but no, I don't think he's a good fit. So the other consideration for Brian Goodwin is he only costs $3 million, but I can probably get somebody else too. I know he's not a great left fielder, but he's also super young, right? Which means there's a good chance he'll get better. Where did you come from? Are you just an undrafted free agent? I'm willing to give this a chance. We're gonna try it. We're gonna try it. All right, so Brian Goodwin has been offered. Let's look at infielders. Shortstops in particular, to be certain, but just in general. And I don't even want to talk to anybody who can't handle shortstop defensively. Actually, I guess I'm really looking for like utility guys, so I suppose I could be a little bit more, I could be a little bit leaner on it. Paul Yanish is a really good shortstop that can't hit at all. I don't think that's the best fit. Now, a guy like Tomas De La Rosa is really interesting because he does play third and short quite well. That gives me more options, so I think giving him a one-year deal seems reasonable. And let's try to find a reliever that is just eager to get another opportunity. Because there's always one or two relievers that are looking for another chance. I'm gonna get rid of my filter here, and we're just gonna switch over to all relievers and then go back to the default screen. Yency Brazabon seems like a pretty good cheap investment. It'll cost us basically 3 million. I actually like it quite a lot. I mean, obviously, he's not obligated to actually sign, but it's like, could you just tell us that you fucked? But I'm at least willing to kick the. Oh, but Chris Young is even cheaper. It wasn't that long. Chris Young is actually like genuinely a really good pitcher, but I've already had Chris Young because we had him in Colorado. He has not aged well, has Chris Young. Yeah, let's get us some Yency and see where that takes us. All right, so we've got some contract offers up. Now let's advance a little bit of time. Danny Alvarado, I will give you $200,000 dues. Hopefully, let's look at the contract too closely because it actually does say dollar dues. Lamar, how about an extension instead? The interesting fact of this offseason is going to be, do we have any chance at a mid-tier position play? You give me Roger Bernardina. What, really? You are a freaking prick, Brian Goodwin. I despise you. I loathe you. Roger Bernardino is literally terrible. I have nothing, no desire for him in the least. Is it really Melky time? Is that where I've reached? The thing is, he can't really hit that well anymore. So he's a guy who's calling card his offense and doesn't offense very well. I think JD Drew is too bargain basement even for me. I need a little bit more offense than that. Curtis Granderson is far from perfect, but he's got enough tools. I mean, I'd basically be betting against history though, right? Which is he gonna hit for average at all? Like, if it's around 250, he'll be worth it. They'll also get a search chance to start in a while. Is that the route we want to go? Is there a better choice? There's always Ben Petrick, who's ridiculously cheap and plays a reasonably good left field. Can any of you fuckers hit with any level of skill? Yeah, Merton's getting 20 million. Jesus Christ. I'd go after Nick. I will go after Nick Evans. He's fairly inexpensive. He's got a track record of actually hitting for average. And he's actually a pretty decent left fielder. I think Nick Evans might be just the ticket. Let's give this a go. All right. The draft is going to be critical for us this year. I feel pretty confident we can rebuild the bullpen in the draft, but I'd like to get at least one quality player. We're only picking 22nd though, which is pretty gross. What position is what I most like to acquire? Left field and shortstop, probably. And then best player available, try to develop some actual depth. That would be lovely. Aaron Judge, good baseball player, question mark? This is hilarious to me. Aaron Judge is actually a fairly good outfielder. But, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Wow, what is with all these guys just being awful at defense? There's a lot of reasonably good offers here, though. If I wanted a leadoff hitting style outfielder, I could do a whole lot worse than Malik Smith. Let's pretend I'm not going to look at pitchers right now. Let's just focus on batters. Tyler Naquin apparently can't play the field at all. I mean, I know he's not great at it, but I remember him playing for the Guardians and not being the worst at it. I'm not going to bother with TJ Rivera because he's only got the one skill. Albert Elmora is interesting. He does a couple things really, really well. But I'd still take Malik Smith over him. What about Jose Martinez? Very solid all-around hitter. Brandon Nimmo, okay. Ryan Healy is a good hitter. Trey Mancini is a good hitter. Oh, he's actually not bad in left field. Interesting. Is Mancini the pick? Or do you go with Malik Smith? Malik can play either corner and outfield spot with some skill. He's very fast, and he's a good all-around hitter. I think there's a lot to like about Malik Smith. On the other hand, Trey Mancini is an excellent hitter in his own right. He also has some pop, which not too many other players have in this particular draft. I kind of think we go Mancini. I think Trey Mancini playing in either of the corners is perfectly cromulent. And he's just a really good hitter and is only going to get better. I think Trey Mancini's the pick. That's what I'm going to do. I was hoping I could get greedy and get... Wow, really? I think this is a known issue with the game where it just, like, especially for newer, for players who are a little bit newer... It just fucks with their defense. Or makes them seem like they're a joke. Chad Green seems like a good choice. Let's go ahead and grab him. And Jonathan Holder. Edubre Ramos, why not? That's our bullpen taken care of. Do your thing, scouting director. My question is, do I retract the offer to that one guy? We'll see. Why would I want Rob Wooten though? I don't think so. I've got relievers coming in. Meh. All right, let's do Rule 5 draft time. Is there any of my players? Nope. Eduardo Nunez is still around. He is young and fast. He's not that great an infielder, though, which gives me pause about acquiring him. I mean, Devin Ratliff to be our utility guy seems pretty smart, but I just don't think it's that useful to me. So I'm just gonna skip the draft. Don't need it. Do I want to pull the offer from Nick Evans? I don't think I do. Yes, I do. Everything that Nick Evans does. Trey Mancini does as good, if not better, and costs way less money. So I'm gonna pull your offer and then see what else we can accomplish this offseason with a bit of cash. Okay, we got De La Rosa and Brazoban. Very nice. Is there a premium shortstop on the market that can actually play shortstop? I know I can't afford Elvis Andrews, so I'm not even gonna waste my time. I'd honestly rather just play Avilas at shortstop for a year. Like, I know that seems suboptimal, but it's better that than just about any other choice I've got. So, yeah, I don't hate it. I don't hate it. Trey Mancini, right to the bigs, plays in left field. And then we'll actually wait until spring training to make any other, like, changes of that nature. We are really thin in a lot of ways. Really, really thin. And we're not relying too heavily on players that have bad injury histories, but it is still questionable. And that sounds you have a lot of your money tied up in just two players. So not the best. Not the worst, Not the best. Yeah, we need one more reliever. I'm gonna go ahead and call up Chad Green now. Get that going. And then I need. Either a middle infielder or another outfielder. I can't believe Mike Morris wants $12 million. I don't see him getting that. Like, who values mediocrity that much? Yeah, I'm giving you shit. I am not giving you $12 million. You're ridiculous. I can get Jason Bartlett for $2 million, and he's at least a reasonably good defender. I love how these, like, incredibly awesome players are all on the trade block. Like, seriously, nobody's gonna be able to afford these guys. Like, who wouldn't want fucking Buster Posey? I love Buster Posey. I can't afford him. Can I? No, I cannot. You guys are really expensive. I guess that's why people are trying to trade you. I'd actually be pretty happy about getting Zach Cozart if I could manage that. Should I kick a Brendan Ryan for basically nothing and just stick him at shortstop and accept the fact he won't hit his way out of a paper bag but be brilliant defensively? That's got value to me, guys. That's got reasonably decent value to me. Absolutely take Brett Boshi. Done. Watch how quickly I don't hesitate to take a genuinely excellent shortstop. I'm still going to play Avilas, but I now have a really great defensive shortstop to back him up. That's just house money right now. Piazza Martin. Oh, Pedro Martinez. I didn't even see him. How did I not vote for Pedro? I mean, this version of Pedro Martinez isn't quite as awesome as real Pedro Martinez, but still extremely good. He had a longer career that wasn't quite as dominant, basically. Quite as dominant. All right, amigos. I don't think we're making the playoffs. I truly don't. I'm not saying because I think this team is bad. I'm saying because I think this team is extremely top heavy, and the top isn't heavy enough. Is my concern. How did Chad Green lose like 1,000 points of potential? Or did I get, or did I, no, I got tricked. I got hornswoggled. Yeah, Nick, I don't have a spot for you. I mean, I could sign you and just make you a bench guy. But there are worse bench options, somebody can play first base in both corners. I just don't see that. How much did Matt Merton get? he got his bank. I think this is hilarious for his salary to fucking double. And I think Toronto's going to regret this real fast. If they don't regret it right now, they're going to regret it very, very soon. Because that's just comical to me. The idea that you would pay that much money to a decent player is, wow. Nick Evans signed with Boston and got a minor league contract. Now I kind of wish I had kicked the tires on him again. Oh, well. Holder and Ramos. Cool. And go ahead and do your thing. And go ahead and do your thing here too. We're expecting a lot out of Trey Mancini. Can he deliver it? I think he can. But I also think it's foolish to assume that he can. If we can get Trey Mancini to be like worth 2 or 3 wins, I think we've got a real chance to potentially make, if not noise, at least noises. I mean, sure, losing an important depth piece for 6 weeks is always a great way to start spring training. I love it. It's what I dreamed of. Look, it's cool that people want AJ Cole for whatever reason. Like, I don't think he's all that great. But I'd hope to think I could do better than that. You know what? Let's kick around the idea of trading Mr. AJ Cole and just see what's on tap. What do I actually want? I want a relatively effective utility guy. I'd love a starting shortstop. I'm not delusional enough to mention anybody's going to give me one of those for this little, however. Waka. Jamil Weeks. These are certainly baseball players. Freddy Galvis would be a solid choice if all I wanted was a hitter. But I'm deeply concerned about his actual ability to play defense. Like, I could put him in second base and not feel too bad about that. But you need more out of a utility guy. And he can't play shortstop, which is a big issue for me, too. I mean, to be fair, I'm going to trade for Freddy Galvis if I can't find a better choice. Because he's clearly the best player being offered to me. Get D'Angelo Jimenez. No, thank you. Being fast and kind of playing second base isn't enough for me. Bended like Gordon Beckham. I mean, Beckham is an elite defender. There's no arguing that. Reed Brignac might be almost perfect for us, actually. Actually, factually. I know he can't hit, but he can play a mean infield. And I think that's what we're looking for. Done. I'll bet we probably end up pulling Brendan Ryan out of the lineup, which is a pretty good start. Will we move Enrique Hernandez to DH? Oh, only against left-handed pitching. Can Kyle Schwarber not hit lefties? He's not great against him. So wait, getting Reed Brignac means we just bench Enrique Hernandez? The fuck is wrong with you, game? What bizarre delusions do you have that second base defense is that important? I'm gonna tell you it's not important, but I'm gonna tell you it's not that important. It isn't so important that we play a mediocre hitter over a pretty good defender. That's comical. And we'll play one more game. Beautiful. All right, we're looking at 31 players, of whom 15 are pitchers, three of them gotta go. There's one. There's two. And there's three. This seems like a pretty good setup, I've got to admit. This seems pretty solid from top to bottom. And we'll see how this goes as the season progresses. And Coach Jordan, why did I keep Holder over Ramos? It's because Ramos can't throw his strikes. And there's so much out of just having a reliable guy in the pen that just puts the ball in play that I think he's a much more useful piece to this club. Okay, so long to John Mayberry. I'm putting him in 60-day DL, IL, sorry, by the way, because I don't want him to disappear, but Brignac is just for leaps and bounds more useful. And Austin Jackson can't do anything. He can maybe play the outfield. Here you go. Your opening day, Tampa Bay Rays. I keep wanting to say double rays. They're not called the double rays anymore. Not in this timeline. Let's nuke this and let's start building the lineup the way that we want to build it. Wow, Albert Pujols actually lost a bit. Not like a huge amount, but he's definitely slowing down. That's disappointing. He's still the best hitter on the team, though. Like, I wasn't even gonna pause thinking about where to bat him. Who leads off? It's Jason Hayward. I don't know why I even bother asking that question. It's always Jason Hayward. It's the one skill he's always been good at. So who bats second? I think it's probably Trey Mancini. No, Enrique Hernandez has proven he can maybe bat second. Let's try him. Schwaba is going to play DH. Mancini's going to play left. Then Coco, then Covelli Crisp. Then probably Jojima. And Laurie. And Brendan Ryan. I don't mind Aviles getting regular playing time. I do mind this ridiculous idea that we should bench Hernandez to give Aviles playing time. Like, Hernandez is a really good all-around hitter, and that's what this lineup desperately needs. I know it's not as efficient as putting somebody else to play defense. Duly noted, but yeah. And I'm just going to copy this right over. I think this is what gives us the best chance for success. I like the idea of Aviles getting regular playing time at shortstop. Just giving Brendan Ryan a rest because he's really fucking old and also can't hit. So, is there anything else I need to do with this lineup other than just hope that they hit well? Let me be very clear. I am expecting this team to be just good enough. God damn it. I hit the wrong button. Hang on 1 second, sorry. Sorry about that, friends. I don't know why my throat's been so annoying today. Here. Do your thing. I guess I have to let you make the lineup too, huh? Okay. So, back to my analysis. Do I think this team is going to be great? I don't know. We have quite a few hitters that all have the exact same skill set of being reasonably talented in a few different offensive areas without anybody being dominant. Other than, of course, Albert Pujols. Now, if Kyle Schwarber can ring up 30 bombs or even 40 bombs, that's going to be a huge deal. I mean, that's just going to be massive. I don't think he can necessarily, but we're going to try. Excuse me. But this is very much a patchwork kind of team. And I don't know how well we're going to do. Sorry about that. Got a bit of the hiccups. Let's go up to opening day. I genuinely don't know where we're going to finish this year. We could finish dead last, we could finish first, and neither one of them would surprise me. A lot's going to depend. Basically, here's how I view this offense. We're spending a lot of money on lottery tickets. And we're hoping that if we spend lots and lots of money on lottery tickets, that it's going to end up good for us in the end. And I just don't think that's fair. I don't think that's fair of our team. I don't think it's realistic. I have serious doubts about us performing at a high level. But we could. And that, I think, is the rub. there is a version of this season where everything goes right and we run away with the AL East. It's not a very likely vision, but it is a vision. This basically involves Trey Mancini coming in and hitting 25 or 30 home runs by himself, 40 plus from Kyle Schwarber, and Albert Pujols just, well, being Albert Pujols. Is that realistic? I don't think so. And let's not discount Jason Hayward. I think Jason Hayward could definitely bounce back and prove to be still a valuable asset. I mean, is Kenji Jojima could hit 290 again? Probably not. But he could. Can I get Jojima to stay for one more year? I could. Let's wait, though. Let's wait. That's probably John Mabry. Nobody really wanted him. Sorry, mate. Hey, Jason Hayward getting better. I am all for. Okay, Tampa. All right. Whose contract is up this season? Buchholz, Crisp, Aviles, Masterson, Brazelbon, Jojima, and De La Rosa. I probably can't afford any of them. Because they're all going to want a fairly substantial raise. Just Masterson want. Masterson wants $11 million. Would I rather have Masterson or would I rather have Clay Buchholz? And I think the answer is patently obvious. It's probably going to be Justin Masterson. And I'm not going to be able to easily replace two starters if even I can replace one. So let's go ahead and offer Masterson the deal he's looking for. I want to try to get a team option in here, too. But this seems actually pretty reasonable for me, for a mid-rotation kind of guy. Why is the All-Star game happening? Oh, that's just when it starts. Okay. The voting starts. Okay. Talk about a position I have no depth at. I don't even know if I have another catcher on the roster. I have Dan Butler. Hey, Dan. Surely there's got to be a catcher I can acquire. Like, surely. Don't call me Shorely. Okay, fine. But, I mean, I will happily take Giovanni Soto. If that's what this is going to be about. Yeah, let's get Giovanni Soto. I'll give you a freaking major league contract for the minimum right now if you just sign. There we go. We did get Masterson. That's excellent news. If I also sign Clay Buchholz, I literally have nothing else. I like how Giovanni Soto is just a worse version of Roberto Perez. But that's okay. We all need a little help sometimes. At least the real life Roberto Perez can actually hit homers sometimes. On occasion. Yeah, I don't buy into Clay Buchholz enough to automatically give him that contract extension. Like, if I re-sign you, I then have no money. Again. And it's not as though there's anybody whose contract is coming up that's going to make a difference. So I think for the sake of any kind of payroll flexibility, I've got to let him walk. Which means if we're super out of it by the trading deadline, Clay Buchholz is going to be on the move. I mean, I'll give you an offer, but I can't meet it. Like, genuinely speaking, there's just a lot of players I can't afford to bring back. I have Brignac, and I have Brendan Ryan, and De La Rosa can't hit at all. I guess he can kind of hit. Let's trade you for a prospector regular of any stature. Anybody at all who could potentially be a useful player for next season. Willie Peralta, probably not so much, or is he a good choice? He's thoroughly mediocre. He's a right-handed sidearmer, and that creates real issues for me. I'm not convinced he's an awesome fit. I think Peter Bourgeois just kind of feels dumb. Hanser Alberto is literally useless. He has no use. Like, I get it. The benefit of Peter Bourgeois is he's really good defensively. The downside of Peter Bourgeois is he can't fucking hit. And maybe I just need to be a little bit less selective. I just need warm bodies that I can trade for other players down the line. I think I gotta go for Peralta. I think he's the best choice here. I know Peralta isn't gonna be anyone's idea of a megastar, but what he is very, very competent and a useful piece. If we do trade Clay Buchholz, I think Peralta can fill in and not be a complete embarrassment. And that's damning with faint praise. It's damning with faint praise. It's the best enthusiasm I can muster for a player of his ilk. Any cool stuff here? Not really. Chad Green, not even green. Disgusting. Ooh, added a new pitch. Very spicy. That makes you much more dangerous, actually. Makes you a lot more dangerous. Trey Mancini is actually having. Okay, so I said a couple things had to go right for seven elite lineup. One that hasn't started going right yet is Kyle Schwarber. He's hitting bombs and he's drawing walks, and that's very good. He is on pace at 30 home runs. So I wouldn't mind him unlocking another gear, but I'm also happy with this. Albert Pujols is still really freaking good. Trey Mancini has been amazing. Almost too amazing. I am deeply concerned that this is not going to last. He's gonna burn out as the season progresses. For right now, though, over the moon. Enrique Hernandez probably should not be batting second. Guys, I can't figure out Brett Lowry. I genuinely cannot figure him out. He's just so good at times, and he generally can't continue that. So the lineup isn't incredible. The lineup does give me a tiny bit of heartburn because, like, there are four players right now that are unqualified successes. Jason Hayward, Albert Pujols, Kyle Schwarber, and Trey Mancini. Brett Lowry, for right this minute, is in that category too. We have one dumpster fire, Roberto Perez, and then a bunch of players who are in the meh range. Enrique Arenas should not be batting second on this team. But I also don't have a better choice. Unless it's Mike Aviles. And maybe it is Mike Aviles. Maybe playing Mike Aviles at second base gives us both a really good contact hitter and a pretty good second baseman. For right now, let's try to leverage Mancini as best we can and have him bat second. This could totally wreck the lineup, by the way. It could totally screw it over because people aren't going to want to pitch to Pujols, or this could mean that Mancini gets all the meatballs, and that would be a wonderful consequence. But it also could mean he gets none of the meatballs, and that would be unkind. Hey guys, Brendan Ryan is hitting somewhere around league average. Given his defense, I will frickin' take that. But I'm not gonna give him a raise. Not until I'm sure that he is the answer. I mean, if this team is gonna be great, it's gonna be based on our pitching. And so far, the pitching's been pretty solid. Let us proceed in a forward fashion to July and see if this trend continues. Kenshi Jojima is ready to return. Kenshi Jojima can no longer catch. I think he gets traded. It's going to make the fans grumpy, but I literally have no incentive to keep him now. None. You're a De La Rosa. I think you're it. Do I have other captains? I don't. I'm not going to trade for a captain for the sake of trading for a captain, but I wasn't also going to carry Jojima. That seemed pretty silly to me. A backup catcher that can't catch is an issue. The Lou Marson. No, I don't need to just constantly retread average catchers. Trading Keon Broxton would probably fetch something of interest. Right? Like, somebody has to look at Broxton and go, yeah, that's a DH. Or that's a reasonably effective corner outfielder. His value ain't going to be any higher than it is now. So what could I get if I traded him? Let's find out. Jimmy Nelson. I could give my choice a reliever. Let's look at all batters. Is there a hitter here to get excited about? I mean, Billy Hamilton is really fast. He's even a pretty decent center fielder. I could do a lot worse than Billy Hamilton. He's probably more useful to us as a player than Broxton. Now, the thing is, he can't hit at all. And I'd like somebody a little bit more well-rounded. Peralta, Nick Franklin. Nick Franklin is a pretty helpful bat off the bench. He plays lots of positions with some skill, and he's a reasonably okay hitter. But maybe I'm looking at this in the wrong way. What if instead of trading for a hitter, I trade for a pitcher and then trade Buchholz? Jimmy Nelson has stuff, movement, and control, a nice fastball, slider, splitter, changeup mix. There's a lot to like about him. And I think I'm gonna do it. And then we trade Clay Buchholz. But if we trade Clay Buchholz, it has to be for a hitter. But again, I want to trade him at his maximum value, and it's unlikely to be better than it is right now. To a contending club who's looking for an excellent pitcher, I have to think he's got a ton of. Really? Does fucking Buchholz have a no trade clause? Ugh! Damn it. The best laid plans of mice and men. Let's put you on the 40 man and send you to AAA. This is just to get you guys reps. This means I do need to find an outfielder to replace him. It can be Austin Jackson for right now. That's foolish. Surely there's got to be an outfielder that's looking for a job this late in the season. Bringing in Melky Cabrera at this point would just be funny. Is there a reason not to do it? I don't think so. He's such a good hitter and such a valuable bat off the bench. I think this makes a ton of sense. Let's do it. I forgot you told me to upgrade a catcher. That's my bad. That's what we call a whoopsie in the business. Go ahead and do depth charts. Okay. Perfect. Are any of these coaches worth keeping? Probably not, but we can at least check. I don't hate a buddy here. He seems like a decent choice to stick around. Tom Gorman is a decent manager. I wouldn't call him a good pitching coach, though. I'll still keep him just for lack of a better decision for right now. Sure, I'll take Ron Gant. I feel like I'm extending people just to extend them, so I have to worry about it, but I guess that's reasonable. Jordan Alexander. Jordan. Cool. John Lackey and Giovanni Gallardo and Ken Giles will make the roster. As of Jason Hayward. But not Albert Pujols. That makes me kind of sad. I mean, I guess Albert Pujols isn't having that amazing a season, but he's still pretty darn good. I mean, we have a lot more all-stars than I expected, so. You have Carlos Correa, you're playing the first base. That entertains me. That gives me the giggles. Tee hee 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 hee. I have no idea who Brian Ellington is, but congratulations, my friend. Congratulations. I just really don't see much point in keeping Clay Buchholz. I think he's kind of an odd choice to keep around. I mean, this just saves us money and gets us an improvement at catcher. He's better than Soto. He's kind of a jerk, though. No, I think I have to pass on this. I keep using Lou Marson with Lou Merlone. Because remember, Lou Merlone is like Nomar's best friend, so teams would keep trying to sign him just for the hopes that he would show up. Which is pretty funny. Damn, look at fucking Pujols and Hayward going off. Lovely. All right, Coco. Absolutely not. Cease thy ridiculousness. If you want to stay in Tampa, you're gonna have to change your tune real fast. Although the instant I signed him, Melky Cabrera can no longer play the field at all. That's hilarious. In so many wrong ways. Is there anybody here worth keeping? Avilas wouldn't take a pay cut, I don't think, and I'm not gonna keep him just for that. Buchholz wants a raise. I can't afford that. I could trade Brazobon. Like, he's pitching fine, but I have people in the minors who can pitch this well, if not better. I think flipping him for a profit makes a ton of sense. So let's try it. Let's flip you for a prospect or regular of any flavor. What is Danny Worth? I'm hilarious, I know. If I only ask for prospects, this list just goes blank at that point. Oh, here we go. I just can't stop thinking how hilarious it is. How you just like casually are like Buster Posey's the worst. I can't trade Gallardo. I could trade Clay Buchholz if he's willing to not be a jerk about it. But he is willing to be a jerk about it. Damn it. Give me Buster Posey. Jerks. Are there anything center fielders? I definitely can't afford Franklin Gutierrez, even if he wasn't hurt. Literally, all these guys have contracts that are expiring, so I could just sign them in free agency if I really cared. Yeah, I'm not trading for Giancarlo Stanton because I'm not gonna lose. I'm gonna trade for Yan Plaerts because it's because I can keep him. Have a chance to keep him. Sigh. Like Buster Posey would be absolutely perfect. But there's no way in hell that they're gonna trade him for something. Oh, he's actually in through 2023. Oh, dear God. I can't. I cannot. Can I? A 29-year-old player in the prime of his career. But is also gonna, again, cripple our financial flexibility. Gallardo is on such a reasonable contract. I can't give you Schwarber. I absolutely cannot give you Schwarber. What could I offer you? I could offer you Roberto Perez and Giovanni Soto. I'd love to offer you Clay Buchholz, but the fucker won't leave. So the question is trading Brazobon and Schwarber worth posing? In one sense, unquestionably, Kyle Schwarber is a designated hitter, will never be anything more than a designated hitter. However, there's also this. Is Buster Posey worth that kind of money? He's an elite player at a difficult defensive position who's really durable. So, in a lot of ways, the answer to that question is yes. They're getting a really good young player. And this is gonna cripple our financial flexibility. But a guy like Buster Posey is so bloody good. Oh gosh. I'm not going to get a better catcher than Buster Posey. That is a fact. That's going to make the owner really happy because they're trading for a massive upgraded catcher. Or do I keep Schwarber and trade Gallardo? Gallardo was so good, though. I could trade Hayward, but then I'd lose my leadoff guy. Then I would Buster Posey hit leadoff. Hayward is such a good player, though. He's a designated hitter. He will never be anything other than a designated hitter. You could hit 55 home runs a year, and that would be amazing and very helpful, but he's a DH. I have to do it. I have to do it. Done. Oh, that feels kind of gross, but the value is phenomenal. Like, we just took a weak spot and made it not only into a strength, but like a definitive strength. I can bench Roberto Perez's stupid ass. It's an amazing story for everybody. How like have Melky Cabrera DH the rest of the year? Well, replacing Brazoban will obviously be Edubre Ramos. That's a given. What is not a given is who plays DH. I could put Enrique Hernandez at DH and let Mike Aviles play second, where he's actually exactly as good as him. Okay. I'm gonna trade Mike Aviles, and I'm gonna try to get a DH. Just a really freaking good hitter for him. Damn it. What about Nolan Reimold? No, that's absurd. Let's look at batters, please. Generally, a player here would have like a really good offensive reputation in real life. That'll give me an idea of who would be worth looking at. A lot of you guys were never good hitters, though. Chris Carter has the thump of Kyle Schwarber and literally nothing else. He is a actually somewhat rich man's Kyle Schwarber. I'm looking for is just a really decent hitter. Aggressively competent. Is that Brennan Bosch? Maybe. Is there like a big time hitter just sitting on the free agent market? I mean, bringing in Shinsu Chu at this point would make him a pretty decent number two hitter. Let me shift everything else down. I think we do it. Mr. Chu, I would like you to join us, please. I beg of you. Oh shit, you're not gonna be able to play in the playoffs if we make the playoffs. It could be John Mayberry. It's not gonna be, but it could be. That would be funny. What about for Michael Carrara and Mike Aviles? There's so many players here that are like almost good enough, but they have some deep, deep flaw that causes me to think a second time. Lucas Duda is genuinely a fairly decent choice, actually. Yeah, let's make it happen. I'm not going to overthink this. He's a very talented hitter, and I'm just looking for a DH. So there we go. All right. So, out of the lineup. Out of the lineup. Into the lineup. Into the lineup. I think having Posey bat second and Mancini bat cleanup makes the most sense. And then we're going to bring in Luke Duda to hit DH. He's quite the Duda. And then I'm going to just bump him up the lineup. I really wish the game would stop going, ooh, Coco Crisp fast, therefore leadoff man. Please don't game. Please. Okay. Let us recalculate the depth charts, because I guarantee fucking to you, yeah, he is not playing every three games now. Buster Posey can play any game he wants to at any position. If Buster Posey tells me, I want to play shortstop now, then he's a fucking shortstop. Okay. Now, this is obviously going to completely obliterate any financial flexibility I will ever have again. And I don't really care. Is the thing. I don't really care. Because it's that good to have the players that we have. I do feel pangs about Kyle Schwarber. I genuinely do. And if Clay Buchholz wouldn't have been such a fucking putz and refused to waive his no-trade clause, then we would have been in even better shape. Because I happily would have handed him over for... instead of Schwarber. But that wasn't an option, so that's fine. It's great. It's not great. Oh, it's such a kick in the junk. I was never going to give up the other players, though. That's the issue. Because Jason Hayward is a complete player that does lots of things well. Gallardo is an amazing pitcher at a frankly criminal salary. He's making slightly more than Justin Masterson. I have no problem with Justin Masterson, but he ain't Giovanni Gallardo. He isn't. And I think he would be the first to agree with you. So we'll see what happens. This is an issue. I don't have a backup middle infielder. Why? I sure don't. I require your finest shortstop. I require a shortstop. I'll reunite with Eric Ivar for old time's sake and let him play shortstop if that's what this is forcing me to do. Disgusting. Done. .3000 hits for Albert Pujols. Nice. I like how Reed Brignac is now instantly like. I guess Eric Ibar is just gonna be here to be like a backup. That's reasonable. And I got Shin-Soo Choo. Now I don't really want him anymore, but I have him. Okay, so we're gonna do Reed Brignac at shortstop. He's the obvious replacement there. Shortstop. And redo the depth charts, please. Albert Pujols is going to be our new DH. Yikes. Cool. Is fucking Nelson hurt again? Holy shit, guys. No wonder Cleveland gave him up so easily. I just want Peralta to get a little bit of pitching in the majors for the rest of this season. And then see how that goes. Not Matt Maloney. Buchholz, I can't afford you at all. It is impossible. Okay, we did get Brendan Ryan back, which is excellent. That means I can dispose of Eric Ibar as I wish. And I do wish. Actually, I don't have to do that right now. Because here's the thing. Ibar is not going to be able to make... Oh, I guess Ibar can make the 40-man. Okay. But I definitely want Brendan Ryan playing shortstop. Like, I know Brignac is a better hitter. But Ryan is, like, an outstanding defender. And I think that's just more important to me. In the guise of having the best possible team, is having that elite defender. Even if he's not hitting that great because he doesn't have to on this team. Generate depth chart, please. Three homers for the frickin' Tampa Bay Rays. I mean, we made the playoffs, which is frankly better than I thought we'd do at the beginning of the season. Okay. So, who is not making the playoff roster? I'm actually fine with this. I'm fine with keeping Ibar and dumping Giovanni Roberto Perez. Starting to playoff coverage. Clay Buchholz isn't my first choice to play the one and only game we might actually get this offseason, this season. But it's not like I prefer anybody else, so... I'll tell you what we're going to do. Like, this is the definition of an elimination game. I at least want to see if we can maybe have a bit of a run in the playoffs here. So let's go ahead and play the game as a treat. Y'all are not getting any desktop audio. It could be just because I have it minimized. Let me just make sure. No, it'll be a thing. Okay. I'm gonna pop back in here. Let's go ahead and let Buchholz do his thing. Very crispy of you. Very crispy. Damn, Nick Castellanos is a pretty scary dude. When you strike him out with a curveball, that warms the cockles of my heart. And Nick Markakis. Markakis. Damn it, Posey. That's one of the reasons you're here. Oh my god, Buchholz. This is extremely bad. Like, thank god that we recovered, but him getting walk happy is not a great start. Hayward, you're gonna draw some walks here. Is it really a strike if it's against Jason Hayward? I don't think that's allowed. Yeah, just do your thing at this point, Hayward. Yeah, that's more than stealing a fucking strike. That is highway larceny. Buster, make this fool pay. That's an out. That's not cool, dude. Really make that nice of a running catch. I mean, it was a good catch. Oh, come on, you fucker. How freaking dare you? You don't hit Albert Pujols, alright? Just wait until Javier Baez comes up. You'll get to see what happens. Like, I'm sorry, you don't fuck around with Albert Pujols. You just don't. I mean, this is going to come down to Clay Buchholz versus Matt Harvey, and Matt Harvey is unquestionably the better pitcher. So this is... we'll see what happens. I'm not writing anything out yet. All it takes is some well-timed swings, and we're going to be in possibly a position to make a little bit of noise. And right now the noise is a farting noise. A big, fat... Laurie almost beat that out. That was kind of impressive, actually. Don't let a fucking jerk like this guy get a home run. Really? Devin Masarocco did it 15 homers this season, but that's still gross, Buchholz. I wonder if Castellanos or Baez is their best player. It's Baez. Really, dude? Just do whatever, Brendan Ryan. If you got on base, that'd be cool, but I don't expect you to. Let's start wearing down Matt Harvey. That's going to be the key here, is just getting players to take some pitches, get into good hitters counts, and then see where we end up. Harvey is so damn good, though. He's, like, right around the plate every time. It does make it more difficult. Yeah, just do whatever. Protect with two strikes. That's an out. Oh, that's out. Nicely done, Posey. Nicely done. I love how the outfield was just like, we're like, yep, we're not going to bother chasing that. That seems like work. I'd like to see Albert go and Posey go back to back, but that's fine. Did you think I fucking forgot? Don't boo at me. Blame your fucking jerk pitcher. Honestly, if I lose this game because I hit Javier Baez, I don't care. I'm gonna enforce these unwritten rules or die trying. That could have been a 6-4-3 if Laurie was a bit more on top of things. Oh my gosh! And you missed the throw. Bruh. Oh, there we go. That's probably it for Buchholz. Buchholz hasn't had great stuff all game. Let's bring in Mr. Ramos. That seems reasonable. That seems eminently reasonable. That's a nice piece of a lazy fly ball, Mancini. Kinda not cool. Really, dude? You didn't have to make a ridiculous catch like that. You could just let it drop. No one would have thought any less of you. Damn it. Yeah, you're done, Buchholz. I know technically he was still having a quality start, but it's literally if we don't win this game, we're done. So we're gonna pull out as many stops as we can. I mean, I didn't really want him to hit a leadoff double. That was kind of lame. There we go. Nice. Here's what I'd like you to do, guys. I'd like you to score at least one run this inning. I definitely can't let him pitch a second inning. I'm gonna warm up Jonathan Holder. That's an out. It's a loud out, but it's an out. And Brendan Ryan ain't gonna do anything. Go ahead and pitch to Bobby Crosby just because the next guy isn't ready to come in yet. Okay, let's bring you in now. Nice. We've got to wear down Matt Harvey. We've got to start taking pitches and just make him pitch behind the count. And then we can start trying to load up and clobber stuff. Damn it, Harvey, quit with your stupid pinpoint control. How am I supposed to compete with that? Like, every pitch was perfect. You could have even argued that slider was actually, like, a hit. Or a strike, a ball. Come on, Pujols. Be a hero. I'll take that. Come on, youngster. Wow, a double play. Just what we didn't need. Damn it, Mancini. Would you quit? Just stop hitting entirely? No, I said stop hitting. I don't think he was safe, but I do think we're in a lot of trouble. Okay, if you're gonna let him score, go for the double play. Don't be freaking stupid. Pitch around bias. I'd rather walk him than give up a homer. There you go. You know what's fucking awesome? Teams that don't hit into double plays. Oh my gosh. Get in there, Givens. There you go. A nice 1-2-3 inning is appreciated. Okay, we got Matt Harvey out of the game. Now, Jordan Walden is still a really tough pitcher, but I at least feel better about our chances. Because Matt Harvey's just too fucking good this game. Go ahead and get Ken Giles warmed up. I just realized I should have pinch hit for Brendan Ryan and played Reed Brignac at shortstop, but oh well. Okay, there's the pitch, doing pitch things. Neat. I fucking ordered you to stop hitting. Just stop. Okay? I don't know why he didn't even try to throw up to first, but okay. We'd ended the inning anyway. I mean, not that it matters. I mean, it would take a pretty crazy sequence for us to even tie the game, much less win it at this point. And striking out Buster Posey is not the best way to start. I mean, Albert Pujols just chokes in the postseason, it seems like. Yep. We done. Fuck you, Baltimore. You had no business even competing in this game. You should have just rolled over. I kind of want to keep you, actually. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do instead. I'm gonna fire Tony Pena. I'm gonna promote you all the way up to AAA. Because you're actually a really talented coach. We can get Fernando Vina to be my rookie league hitting coach. Wow. Just a rough season. I mean, okay, rough season isn't fair. We won 94-68. We won a lot of games. But it really sucks that... Like, how poetic was it that Clay Buchholz fucked over our season in so many ways? But the icing on the cake is just shitting the bed in the one and only playoff game that we got. That's just, like, the ultimate fuck you move. I almost kind of have to respect it. But it is really annoying. Oh, fuck you, owner. You're not getting better than Buster Posey. Jesus. Buster Posey, you are authorized to beat him to death with your bat. You are allowed to do that, and in fact encouraged to do so. Okay, what went well this season? Jason Hayward put together another outstanding season. I don't have too much to add about that. He got better at all the things and was an amazing player. Coco Crisp was a revelation this season. Coco Crisp was truly special this year and really solidified an area that we've had a lot of trouble with, just center field. He's also priced ourselves out of us ever having him, but it would have been cool if we could have. Albert Pujols is starting to slip. And I don't know what it is about the postseason with us. But take a look at your postseason numbers. You've been dreadful. Except in 2012, when you're actually pretty good. But other than that, like, you just have not come through when we really needed you the most. Actually, I guess he actually has had pretty good postseason numbers for us. Anyway. I said I wanted 30 home runs from Trey Mancini for it to be an awesome season. He didn't get quite to 30, but he did hit almost 300. This is perfect. This is exactly what I want out of my left fielder. I really have nothing to add. Enrique Hernandez had a really good season, too. Really, really good. Buster Posey could have been better. Brendan Rhine was very useful. Lucas Duda, not so much. Yeah, the lineup was actually pretty good. I mean, the pitching was phenomenal, though. The pitching is what got us as well as it did. And I kind of regret picking Masterson over Buchholz, because Buchholz is clearly the better pitcher. But, oops. You probably were shouting at your screens, and I wouldn't have blamed you. We have such a good pitching staff, though. Like, such a good staff. And why did I assign Justin Masterson instead of Buchholz? I don't know. Then again, Buckleton fucked me in that last game of the season, so he can go to hell. Right to hell. So that's it. I don't think we have the season in us again. Partly because one of our very best players is Coco Crisp. He is gone. I frankly don't see Enrique Hernandez hitting 24 homers again. I think that's a little bit unfair. And I just think there's... there's not a lot of depth offensively on this club. There isn't. So... I don't know what we're going to do next season. We have very little money, and we're going to have plenty of holes to fill. And I don't know how we fill them. Like, truly and faithfully, I do not know how we fill these holes. We're losing a starting pitcher, a center fielder, and our starting shortstop. And we will have $0 to replace them. So, got to think about it. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have, please remember to like and subscribe as of the beginning of the video. I'm going to record the next video as soon as I'm done with this one. So if you have any wisdom or things to share, I want you to feel free to do so, but I won't be able to do anything about them. You can mock me for signing Masterson over Buchholz. I know I mock me for that. But anyway... until next time, this has been Evgardian. Thank you for watching, and I bid you good day.